Hello, and welcome to Merryvale Vineyards. I'm Andrew Wright, the winemaker for Merryvale, and really, really happy to be with you on this virtual wine dinner event with the Wine Vault Bistro. So, wish we could be there in person. I've seen the menu. It looks fantastic. It's going to pair amazingly well with our wines, our selection here for you tonight. It's really sad I can't be there in person. So, you know, next time you're in St. Helena, come on by and we can chat about it. But first things first, why don't we all pour ourselves some Chardonnay? There's nothing worse than talking about wine without actually tasting the wine. So my favorite thing to do is just to kind of settle in and calibrate your palate, see how you feel about where everything's at. So let's taste some Chardonnay. While that's getting kind of poured around and you're tasting, let's talk a little bit about where we are here at Merryvale. Merryvale is the first winery built post-Prohibition, so it's got a very long and storied history. We are coming today from the cask room, the historic cask room at Merryvale. These casks behind me were coopered by a German immigrant in the 1880s. These are original North Coast redwoods. They were in continuous use for 100 years up until the late 80s. I would love to still be using them, but they're for show now, and they're great event space as well, so come on down and check it out. But a little bit about our history at Merryvale, a little bit more. Merryvale was purchased, the first winery purchased by the Mondavi family, so Cesare Mondavi, when he came over as an immigrant from Italy, purchased this in the 50s, before it had been sunny St. Helena. It was purchased by the Harlins in the 80s, and then in the 90s, they became partners with the current proprietors, the Schlatter family, who have now continuously owned Merryvale and operated it since the mid-90s, 1996, 1997, I believe. So family-owned and operated for 80 years, small production, artisanal, you know, hand quality craftsmanship, so in wine form. So a little bit about the first wine. I love Carnero Chardonnay and Pinot, and we are very blessed that we own a historic vineyard down there, part of the historic Stanley Ranch, where we have 40 acres of Chardonnay and Pinot planted to. 75% of the grapes in this wine come from our estate vineyard down in Carneros, and the other 25% come from the Hyde Vineyard, so just across the street, another famous Chardonnay vineyard in Carneros as well. Now, what makes Carnero Chardonnay so appealing to me is it has a combination of this vibrant acidity and freshness, but it also has some of that really nice texture that we've come to love about Napa Valley Chardonnay. You know, where Carneros is, it's the closest point in Napa to the San Pablo Bay. So it's a very northern kind of edge of where the bay climate is and the southern edge of Napa. It's where they kind of meet. And so you still have these maritime influences. You have a lot of nighttime or early morning fog, overnight low temperatures. It can get a little hot in the daytime high, but you know, nowhere near as hot as Calistoga. See, because you know, Napa Valley is so varied with the microclimate. So Carneros is much cooler than, you know, Calistoga is. Obviously with more fog and more maritime influence, so it's a great, great place to grow Chardonnay. So we make this in a kind of a classic Burgundian style. We pick on pH, so low pH. We're trying to make a lower alcohol wine that's better, you know, paired with food, frankly. So we pick this low pH, gets whole cluster pressed to a tank, and that just means we put it into a big bladder press. The juice gets pressed out. We store it in a tank overnight, and the next morning it goes straight down into French oak barrels. We use about 30% new French oak Burgundian barrels for this, and the rest 70% is used. And then what happens is we put those barrels just away in the cellar. Cellar's about 65 degrees during harvest. And then after about a week, that juice will, you know, spontaneously start fermenting. And the yeast it's using is the native yeast that exists on the skins of those grapes. So, you know, we farm organically, we farm sustainably wherever we can. So we have a healthy native yeast culture that exists in the vineyard that also exists in the cellar. After, you know, 80 years of continuous winemaking in the cellar, we have a pretty good house yeast culture, which allows us to do native fermentations, which to me gives the wine a little bit more layered complexity, a little bit more finesse, and also, again, is a house style. So you're not ever going to find another wine that tastes exactly like Merryvale because we have our own, you know, yeast cultures in the vineyard and in the cellar. So, looking at your first course, I'm super jealous. I got a bouillabaisse with some saffron, Chardonnay, that sounds pretty amazing. Hot smoked heirloom tomato salad with some summer stuff. This is perfect for this. I love the Chardonnay because it's so crisp and clean and refreshing, but at the same time, the barrel fermentation gives it that mid-palate weight, a little bit of volume to it. So there's some richness along with the freshness. You know, a lot of people conflate Napa Valley Chardonnay with always these big buttery oaky Chardonnays, and that's just not true. That's more typical of, you know, northern Napa Valley style. But from where we are growing in Carneros, you get a lot of more French kind of classic, you know, bracing acidity, nice tension, but also the ripeness that comes from California. So I love that wine. I hope you do too. Now let's jump over to Pinot. Pinot, of course, the red varietal from Burgundy, grown on the same property as the Chardonnay down in the historic Stanley Ranch. We do have another couple of vineyards that we sourced from this, the historic Brown Vineyard as well, a little bit further north, for those of you familiar with Carneros. And what I love about our Pinot, this is 2016, so a great growing season, a super even vintage with no real crazy heat spikes, is that our Pinots have an earthiness, but also that characteristic Carneros kind of cherry cola, maybe a little bit of dill, a little herbal components to it. But at the same time, it is a little bit more opulent than a typical red Burgundy would be. That's because this uses primarily Dijon clones, Dijon clone 667 for the most part. Dijon clones are kind of a warmer clone from Burgundy that were imported by Washington State University in the late 70s, I believe, and just grow really, really well in this part of the world. So it's primarily what we use for our Pinot. And what we find is that in its youth, it's very powerful and not dense necessarily, but it's a broad Pinot. And with a little bit of age on it, this one's 5 years old now, you really see the beauty and the tertiary kind of flavors coming through, the more forest floor flavors, the things that I really love about classic red Burgundy. So kind of a similar approach to these wines. This is done classic Burgundian style as well. This is a 7-day cold soak, so a little bit longer to extract a little bit more of those aromatics. And when I say cold soak, I mean those berries are put into the tank and left to sit there at 50 degrees for 7 days, and we don't touch them. And then after about 7 days, we'll turn the temperature of the tank up, and then again, it starts spontaneously fermenting with the native yeast that exists on the skins. We use a little bit of stem inclusion, so we'll throw some whole clusters in there just to give it a little bit of antioxidant, you know, power, and then gives it a little bit of minerality, and it just kind of does some funky stuff to the fermentation and the finished product, and we really like the flavor. So talking about flavor, one of the things I love to eat the most with Pinot is pigs, Pinot and pig. That's the classic combination. So you got some bourbon, brine, bone, and pork chops. That sounds amazing to me with this wine. And also, you know, it doesn't sound super, super crazy or complicated or fancy, but one of my favorite dishes of all time is just a classic roast chicken with a bottle of Pinot Noir. And so I see you guys have a pan-roasted chicken with some mushrooms and some thyme. That's one of my favorite meals ever and one of my favorite classic pairings. And I really like Pinot for like these lighter white meats because, you know, it doesn't have the heavy tannin that a Cabernet has. It has full body to it, but the tannins are a little bit dialed down. And what we've amped up with kind of the freshness. So it really complements those kind of lighter meats and those lighter sauces, I think, really, really well. All right, so that's a mouthful. I'm gonna have a little Chardonnay here. Now let's transition to Bordeaux. So we own our vineyard down here in Stanley Ranch. We own another vineyard in Conne Valley, 25 acres just east of the city of Santa Elena here. And we source some of our fruit that comes in the Napa Cab from that vineyard, but also from three other vineyards, I should say, because we believe in truly representing Napa Valley in our Napa Valley Cabernet. Now, there are a lot of people that you know, they have like one vineyard and they'll say this is our Napa Valley Cab, but it really only comes from one vineyard. You know, one of the things that we love about Napa, I personally love about Napa, and I talk about it, you know, ad nauseum, is the fact that of all the known soil types in the world, Napa Valley contains half of them, which is a crazy fact. And then you think about all the different microclimates and terroirs that we have that range from Carneros down at the southern tip all the way up to Calistoga in the north. And what you really have is infinite possibilities for growing grapes. And so what we do is we source from four different vineyards for this wine. We have a little bit that comes off of our estate in Conne Valley. We have some Cabernet that comes from Stagecoach Vineyard on Atlas Peak, some from Rancho Chimiles, so kind of on the backside of Atlas Peak closer to Napa. And then we have some off of Hardman Lane, so just south of the Stag's Leap District. And so what we have in this wine is we have, you know, all the different microclimates, we have different soil types, we have alluvial soils, volcanic soils, you know, sandy loam soils, like all kinds of crazy soil series. But then once it comes into the cellar, we treat it very classic Bordeaux style. So this sees a 5-day cold soak as opposed to a 7-day on the Pinot. We turn up the tank and then we'll use native yeast and a little bit of cultivated yeast as well because, you know, Cabernet has a tendency to ferment hot and give high alcohol wines. So we use different yeast strains to kind of restrain where we want to and then like kind of bring out boldness where we want to as well. And the end result, I think, is a really, really great classic example of the potential and what the representation of what Napa Valley Cabernet should be to me. It's very luscious, It's very soft, but at the same time, it's got broad shoulders. It's got a long finish, and it's got, I think, one of those mid palates that kind of leads into the long finish. All the great wines in the world, to me, have a nice mid palate that kind of goes into a super long, smooth finish, and this wine definitely has that. Again, talking about the 2016 vintage, this is a 2016 Napa Valley Cabernet. 16 was a year where, for the Cab, it was another really beautiful year because we didn't have a drought. We had a nice winter rain that kind of filled the water tables, and even kind of growing season. You know, as a winemaker, the last thing you want is a crazy weather event towards, you know, when you have to pick the grapes. Whereas in 16, pick them whenever you wanted, which is kind of luxury. So all told, just a really classic example and representation of that vintage. And look at what you're pairing it with, the pepper-crusted venison loin. It's fantastic pairing to me. I love gamier meats, heavier beef dishes with Cabernet because the tannin, I think, stands up to the fattiness of the meat, also the richness of the meat. The mid palate, the flavor, I think it's all combined texturally. It's a fantastic pairing. So yeah, these are our wines. I'm happy to give you guys a little bit of an insight into Merryvale Vineyards. These are just three of the wines that we make. So we make a wide range of Cabernets, Pinots, and Chardonnays. These are just a few. So again, thank you so much for having us with you tonight. I hope you enjoy the wines, and I hope you enjoy the pairings. And we hope to see you all again soon. Cheers.